Hi students, today in this video we'll start the new topic, that is 7th topic in the 12th chemistry syllabus, elements of groups 16, 17th and 18th, which are called as P block elements. In last year in 11th standard you have studied about the periodic table and the elements which are present in P block, that is elements of group 13, 14 and 15. Now if you consider the periodic table, here all the elements are classified in different blocks on the basis of the electronic configuration. The classification is, the elements which are present in first and second group, these are called as S block elements. From third to 12th group, these are called as D block elements. And here from 13th to 18th group, these are called as E block elements, and here these elements are called as F block elements. In the periodic table you have studied in detail. This is the classification which is based on the electronic configuration. Now you know that here we have to concentrate on P block elements. In this topic we have to study about the elements which are present in 16th, 17th and 18th group, because in 11th standard you have studied about the elements which are present in 13th group, that is boron family, carbon family and nitrogen family. These elements we have studied in detail. Now in this topic we have to consider about the elements which are present in 16th, 17th and 18th group. Now you know that here in P block elements, the elements have the electronic configuration in which the last electron enters in P subshell, and here the maximum number of electrons which can be present in P subshell are 6, and so there are 6 groups, and the electronic configuration of 13th group, that is if you consider the last electronic configuration, outermost electronic configuration, here it is, it will be NS2, here NS2 and NP1. Like this, the 13th group elements have the electronic configuration as NS2 and NP1, NS2, NP2, NS2, NP3, like this here. Now we will concentrate on the 16th, 17th and 18th group elements. Here if you consider 16th group elements, these elements are oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium. Now these elements are called as, or this family is called as oxygen family. Now these elements, oxygen and sulfur, you know that most of the ores, most of the metals, these are in the form of their oxides and sulfides. That means these are the elements which can form the ores, and so these are called as ore forming elements. Remember, the elements which are present in group 16th, they are called as ore forming elements. Why these are called as ore forming elements? Because most of the metals are in the form of their oxides and sulfides, and so ore forming elements, or these are called as chalcogens. Remember, these elements are called as chalcogens because they are ore forming elements. Now if these elements, if you have to consider how these elements occur in nature, now if you consider the occurrence of these elements in nature, remember, see here, these are called as chalcogens or ore forming elements. Now the first element is oxygen. Here in air, near about 20.95% of the air by volume contains oxygen. Remember here, near about 20.95, that is we have studied it, that 21% of the air contains oxygen. And if you consider by mass in earth crust, the oxygen is in the form of 46.6%. Remember, oxygen is present in the gaseous state. Now the second element is sulfur. Here sulfur is obtained in sulfates, in the form of sulfates. The 0.034% of mass of earth crust is containing sulfur, and here sulfur is mainly obtained in the form of sulfates like calcium sulfate, which is called as gypsum salt. Now you know what is gypsum. Gypsum is CaSO4 twice H2O. This is water of hydration. So gypsum, that is calcium sulfate. Ipsum, that is magnesium sulfate. The formula is MgSO4 7H2O. Barium sulfate, that is called as barite sulfides. Now these are sulfates and sulfides. What is the difference here? In sulfates, sulfur is in the form of SO4 minus minus radical, and in sulfides, sulfur is in the form of S minus minus radical. Now you know the ore of Pb, that is lead, is galena, PbS lead sulfide. It is called zinc blend, zinc sulfide. Copper pyrites, CuFeS2. These elements, that is Pb, zinc and copper, they are extracted from these ores, and so these are the ores of the, this is, that is the PbS is the ore of Pb, which is called as galena. Zinc blend is the ore of zinc, which is called as which has the molecular formula ZnS. Copper pyrite, CuFeS2. Like this, sulfur is obtained in the form of sulfates or sulfides. Now the next elements are selenium and tellurium. These are obtaining in very less form, and these are present in the sulfide ores, which are in the form of selenides or tellurides. That is, selenium is in the form of selenides, metal selenide, and tellurium is in the form of tellurides. Now polonium is the decay product of thorium and uranium. You know that what is decay, that is thorium, uranium, these are the radioactive elements, and by decay of these elements you can obtain polonium. Like this, these are the elements which are present in group 16, and they are obtained in the nature in different forms. That is, oxygen is in the form of oxygen gas, which is present in air. Sulfur is in the form of sulfates or sulfides. Selenium is in the form of metal selenides or tellurides, that is, it combines with metal. And polonium is the decay product of thorium and uranium. Now, if you consider the elements of group 17 elements, if you consider here, remember, group 17 elements are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine. These are the elements which are called as halogens. Remember, fluorine, which has the atomic number, fluorine has the atomic number 9, chlorine atomic number 17, bromine 35, iodine 53, astatine 85. These elements are called as halogens. Why these are called as halogens? Remember here, halogen, halo, this is the Greek word having the meaning salt, and gen means bond, and so these are called as salt producing elements. Now you have studied about the electronegativity. Halogens are very reactive. If you consider the reactivity, these are the most reactive elements. Why these are very reactive? Because their electronegativity are high. If you these elements cannot be obtained in free state. What is electronegativity? It is the tendency to attract the shared electron pair or electron pair. That is, they have more tendency to attract the electrons so that they can have the electronic configuration of nearest inert gas. So if you consider the electronic configuration, here only one electron is less than the nearest inert gas. So these halogens have more tendency to attract the electrons, to gain the electrons. So their electronegativities are more. And so these elements are not obtained in free state. Remember, these are called as halogens because halogens means the salt producing elements. Halogens are called as salt producing elements. Now these are very reactive due to high electronegativities. Now how these elements are obtained in nature? Remember, fluorine is most electronegative element, and it is obtained in the form of insoluble fluorides. It is obtained in the form of insoluble fluorides. here CaF2 fluorspar, it is called cryolite Na3AlF6. These are the ores, and cryolite Na3AlF6, fluoropatite, that is Ca3PO4 thrice. Here thrice Ca3PO4 thrice. These are called as ores of fluorine, which is obtained, it is in the form of insoluble fluorides, that is calcium fluorides, you can say sodium aluminium fluoride. Here these elements are obtained, that is fluorine is obtained in the form of here these ores. Fluoropatite, the formula CaF2, here we have thrice Ca3PO4 thrice CaF2. Remember, small quantity of fluorine is present in soil. It is present in soil, in fresh waters, in plants, in bones and teeth of animals also. Fluorine is present in very small quantity. Now, here in seawater, remember the other halogens are chlorine, bromine and iodine. Here chlorine, bromine and iodine is in the form of chlorides, bromides and iodides of sodium, magnesium, potassium, calcium. In seawater, you can obtain these salts, that is salt of sodium, sodium chloride, sodium bromide, like this, salt of magnesium, salt of potassium, calcium. These salts, chlorides, bromides and iodides are present in seawater. Here NaCl is in large quantity, that is it is 2.5% by mass. Now seabeds contains NaCl and carnelite, that is the salt of here KCl, MgCl2 and 6H2O. Iodine is obtained in seaweeds. You know that seaweed is one type of algae which is present in the sea water. At the bottom of sea, you can obtain the algae containing iodine, here which contains 0.5% of iodine. Now chili saltpeter, which contains chili saltpeter, that is sodium nitrate NaNO3, it contains 0.2% of sodium iodate. Now the last is astatine. This is a radioactive halogen. Remember, this is the radioactive halogen element astatine, which has the half-life period is 8.1 hours. The last member of halogen family, that is astatine, it is radioactive, having half-life period 8.1 hours. So these are the halogens, which are called as salt producing elements, which are the most active reactive elements due to the high electronegativities, and these are the ores, or these are the occurrences of these elements. Now the last group, that is 18th group elements, you know these elements are called as inert gases or noble gases. Why these are called as inert gases or noble gases? Because here the last shell of these elements is completely filled, and so these elements cannot react with another element, so their reactivity is very less, and so these are called as noble gases or inert gases. The first is helium, having atomic number 2, neon, then argon, krypton, xenon and radon. Remember here, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon, these are the elements which are called as inert gases or noble gases. Now except radon, all these noble gases are present or are occurring in the atmosphere. In dry air, near about 0.1%, remember here, if you consider in dry air, here these elements are near about 0.1% by volume, and in dry air the major constituent, that is in large amount, argon is obtained. Helium, its source, main source of helium is a natural gas. You know, natural gas is the mixture of gases which contains hydrocarbons in large quantity. This main source of natural, the helium is natural gas. Now helium and neon, they can be obtained from these ores which are radioactive, that is pinchblende, it is the source of ore of uranium, monazite and cleveite. These are the ores which are, you can say, radioactive. These elements, the helium and neon, can be obtained in these ores also. Now xenon and radon are the elements which are the rarest elements, and radon is the decay product of radium. You know that radium is radioactive. By decaying, radon is obtained, and radon is also radioactive element. Now xenon and radon, they are not obtaining in nature, because you can call them as the elements which can be obtained from uranium or decay products. So here remember, these are the noble gases. All these elements, that is the elements which are present in 16th, 17th and 18th group elements, in this topic we have to study about all these elements in details. Now we shall consider what is the electronic configuration of these elements. What is the electronic configuration of these elements we have to consider. See here, the electronic configuration, if you see, of the elements which are present in 16th group, the general electronic configuration is 16th group elements. If you consider, the last electronic configuration is NS2NP4, that is NS2 nth shell, S subshell is completely filled, S block elements electronic configuration if you consider, and NP4. That means if you consider the electronic configuration of nearest inert gas, then only two electrons are less than the nearest inert gas. That means the inert gas have the electronic configuration NS2NP6. Here there are NP4. NP4 means two electrons are less, so they can obtain or they can gain two electrons. Group 17 elements, the electronic configuration is NS2NP5. These are called as halogens, so all these halogens have the electronic configuration, general electronic configuration, NS2 and NP5. That means one electron is less than the nearest inert gas, so they have the more electronegativities. And the elements which are present in group 18, they have the electronic configuration NS2 and NP6. That means here the P subshell is completely filled, and so these are inert gases. Remember, the chemical properties of these elements or the reactivity of these elements depends upon the electronic configuration. So you have to remember the electronic configuration of all these elements. Now in this next video, we'll consider about the periodic properties like atomic radius, ionization enthalpy, electronegativity. What are these properties, you know? Now what are the trends of these properties in different groups, we have to consider in the next video.